Welcome back, students. We were seeing nutrition in animals and plants, and now in this session we will see the digestion in ruminants. Okay, now first of all, what are ruminants? Ruminants are the animals in which mainly the grazing animals are involved. Okay, grazing animals means the animals which mostly survive on, or you can say which mostly feeds on the grass. Examples for this can be deer, cow, goats. Okay, now why they are called ruminants, that we will see in further session. Now see, digestion of the ruminants mainly involve the special digestive system of the grazing animals. Okay, now they have mainly four chambered stomach parts. First is the rumen, as you can see here. Next is the rectum, third is omasum, and fourth is the abomasum, which is considered as the true stomach. Now what happens is ruminants feed on the mainly the grasses, and you know humans cannot digest the cellulose present in the food, right? But these ruminants have that enzyme which is required for the digestion of cellulose. Okay, now when the goat eat, you can say, or the herbivores eat, grazing animals eat grass, they eat the food and it they eat the grass and store it in the rumen. Okay, that means the half chewed food is swallowed, and first it undergoes from mouth to rumen, the first chamber of the stomach. Now here it is acted upon the bacterias and microorganism. Now this half digested food then goes to the second muscular chamber, that is the reticulum. Okay, now where it is sent back to the mouth from here, which is sent back to the mouth of the herbivores, and which is considered, now that food is considered as curd. The half chewed food which is transferred from reticulum to the mouth is considered as curd, and this action is known as ruminating. That means the half chewed food is again sent back to the mouth for further chewing, is called as rumination. That is why these organisms are called as ruminants. Okay, now this half, the rechewed food is swallowed for the second time by passing the first two chambers, and then it enters to the omasum, where it is again broken down into small pieces, and finally it is reached to the abomasum, that is a true stomach. Okay, where the complete digestion of food it takes place by the action of, you can say, enzymes. Then this digested food is sent to the small intestine, and then undigested food is then goes to large intestine, and then through anus the undigested food is excreted. So like this the digestion takes place in the ruminants. Now we will have a look over the nitrogen cycle. Now what happens in this is plants also require various types of nutrients. So nitrogen is one such nutrient which is required by plants, and plants usually get this nitrogen from the soil. Now how they can take these nutrients from the soil, we will see. You know, atmosphere mostly has various types of gases. Nitrogen is also such gas which is present in the atmosphere. So this atmospheric nitrogen is fixed by nitrogen fixers. They are mostly the microorganisms. Okay, now with the help of this nitrogen fixing, this nitrogen is first converted into, yeah, with the help of the rhizobium, it is converted into this ammonification into ammonium, and then to the nitrate, and then into, you can say, nitrates, and finally through denitrification after nitrate it is converted into nitrates, and it is taken up by the plants for further, you can say, for further growth of the plants. So these bacteria, you know, mostly survive in the legumes of the plants, and they are nothing but, again you can say, have a mutual dependent relationship. So this when you also You can say add the extra nitrogenous fertilizer to the soil in which they are grown. These leguminous crops, whatever are present in the plants, right, they enrich the soil with the nitrogen every time when they are grown. Okay, so this was all about the nitrogen cycle. Thank you, students.